We also had a chance to speak to Professor Stephen Jones, who is a doctor of physics, concerning new bombshell evidence that conclusively proves that thermite was used to cut the main pillars in the World Trade Center towers.
There is this molten material flowing out of the South Tower just before its collapse. There's a large quantity of yellow hot metal. And then I read about these pools of molten metal underneath both towers and Building 7 after their collapses. Now that fits like a glove with the thermite reaction, which produces molten iron. You also see in these videos of this molten metal coming up, you see this white ash, this dust that comes off. Now that combination, yellow hot molten metal, white ash floating away, that's his signature characteristic for thermite. And then finally, we got some samples of this metal, the previously molten metal. Using advanced techniques like proton-induced X-ray emission and electron microprobe, we found out what's in these samples. We're finding iron, also sulfur, potassium, and manganese. And these are characteristic of a variation of thermite, which is used to cut through steel very rapidly. It's called thermate. It's like, sure, you can take a knife, you take the butter out of the fridge, and you cut through that butter. Now, adding sulfur to thermite and also potassium permanganate is chemical. It's like heating up your knife to a very high temperature, not slices right through the butter. Even if the butter's cold, slices right through. Same way here, by adding sulfur and potassium permanganate to thermite, it'll now slice through structural steel very rapidly. But the end products then, you'll have sulfur and potassium, manganese, and iron. And that's what we see. Thermite had to be planted in the buildings, which of course implies directly an inside job. Someone had to have access into the buildings.